everyone, and welcome to the Christmas edition of Let's Talk Tobago. I'm Davia Chambers. Today we're at Fairy's Restaurant and Golf Lounge at Tobago Plantations in Lowlands for a special year in review edition. Over the next half hour, we will take another look at some of our major stories of the past year from right here in Tobago. So sit back as we get started with the headlines. The newly commissioned Barbados Bay Jetty is great news for Tobago's economy. The top 10 SCA students are treated to breakfast as they are recognized for their excellence. Tobago hosts its first multi-sectorial environment conference as the island confronts its environmental challenges head-on, and later, sod is turned in the village of Speyside for a new facility that will help make eastern Tobago more disaster-ready. All these stories and more when Let's Talk Tobago returns. Please stay with us. Fairways Restaurant and Golf Club is managed by Stacia Lindsay, a young entrepreneur. The restaurant offers a wide range of mouth-watering meals, all prepared with a local twist. Now we will head further east as Barbados Bay Jetty reopened right at Studley Park. It's the first time in more than 15 years that the jetty is in operation, and the opening was quite timely, providing significant economic benefits for the island, as Patricia Nicholson explains.
Truckers no longer need to journey 10 kilometers to transport material from the Studley Park quarry to the Scarborough port in preparation for shipment to Trinidad. Now it's a 1 kilometer drive to the Barbados Bay Jetty, where the material is placed on a barge for the sister isle. General Manager of Studley Park Enterprise Limited, Dexter East, says the reopening of the jetty has reduced the cost of transporting construction material from the quarry.
As a result of the road congestion and the transport cost that is associated with trucking overland to the Scarborough port, the cost was exorbitant, and that basically put our product at a disadvantage in terms of competitiveness. In addition to that, our jetty, the Barbados Bay Jetty, is approximately 1 kilometer away from our quarry, whereas the Scarborough port is over 10 kilometers. So right off there will be a saving in rehabilitating this jetty.
Mr. East said 2,200 metric tons of material was sold in the jetty's first shipment for about 15 years.
The actual construction of the LNG train 4 and 5, the actual boulders and aggregate was actually shipped from here. Since then, there has been no further shipment, and on the 26th of January 2019 was the first one since.
Studley Park Enterprise Limited has the potential to service the entire country and the Caribbean with aggregate from Tobago.
We have andesite rock, which is the second hardest material right here in Tobago, a highly demanded resource that we can use to build the future of the region. Exxon just discovered two more oil deposits off of Guyana, which means that they have over 5 billion gallons of oil to be able to pump. Guyana is going to go through a revolution clearly very soon. It means that this material from Tobago can be, and there's already been some interest, I understand, can be used to build the future of Guyana.
THA Chief Secretary Kelvin Charles says he's pleased with how successful the Studley Park quarry has been since its restructuring in 2017.
Operations at the quarry are almost seamless. The quarry is no longer in the news. Sometimes people wonder if the quarry is still around. You know, ladies and gentlemen, we have a propensity to report bad news. So what is good and pleasant is hardly reported. I say congratulations to the board and staff for making the dream a reality.
The chief secretary says the operations at the quarry are much more efficient and require fewer staff. More than 100 people worked at the quarry before its restructuring, and those who weren't re-engaged were redeployed within the Tobago House of Assembly. As for the Barbados Bay jetty, Mr. Charles says it will also be used to ship sand and other material to Tobago. I'm Patricia Nicholson for Let's Talk Tobago.
Fairway stands prominently at one end of Tobago Plantations. The wider plantations property has much more to offer than just an 18-hole golf course. You can try your hand at water sports, take the nature trails less traveled, or lounge on the beachfront if that's what you're into. There's something here for everyone. So now we will continue east and stop in at Bloody Bay Road in Roxburgh. That's where a critical sod-turning ceremony was held earlier this year to mark the start of construction for a new hospital, which is a first for East Tobago communities. Here are the details.
Residents of Roxburgh and East Tobago will no longer be required to travel to Scarborough to access healthcare services when the community's hospital is completed next year. Prime Minister, the Honourable Dr. Keith Rowley, Chief Secretary Kelvin Charles and other members of the Tobago House of Assembly gathered at the site in Bloody Bay to turn the sod, signalling the start of construction of the project, which requires an estimated expenditure of $60 million.
Talks of a new hospital in Roxburgh have circulated through the air for some time. Now the moment is here to signal officially the physical start of the creation of this dream. In doing so, we are setting the scene for the beginning of another monumental chapter for the people of Roxburgh and neighboring communities.
So when you look at the infrastructure for healthcare delivery, it is our view that when we would have completed this phase of our infrastructural development in healthcare, our nation for the first time would have covered the entire population with the healthcare infrastructure that is required to bring healthcare delivery to every single citizen of this country.
The new medical facility will comprise a helipad for emergency airlifts to Trinidad, an accident and emergency room, medical and surgical wards, a newborn nursery, an operating theatre, and an isolation unit. Residents will also be able to access services such as medical imaging, laboratory services, a pharmacy, dialysis, and physical and operational therapy. A new health center will also be built alongside the hospital.
We are here to deliver. We are here to keep our promise for all of Tobago, in this case, all of East and Northeast Tobago. We promise to deliver to you a new primary care service at this site to replace the aging infrastructure at the old Roxburgh Health Centre, in addition to a Roxburgh Hospital.
A hospital in East Tobago will increase the employment opportunities for the community and medical professionals on the island. Residents are excited to finally welcome such a facility to their community.
Oh, I'm very proud about it because it's something that's long in the waiting.
It is a welcome initiative, and I hope that and look forward with bated breath on its completion.
Project developer Uricot intends to take 40% of the labor force for the building of the hospital from the village of Roxburgh. I'm Patricia Nicholson for Let's Talk Tobago.
Tobago was prominent in the 2019 edition of the SEA exams for promotion to secondary school. The island's top SEA students had the honor of breakfast with the chief secretary as a reward for their hard work and inspiration for the journey ahead. More in this story.
The top 10 students of the Secondary Entrance Assessment or SEA exams on the island were treated to breakfast at the Magdalena Grand Beach and Golf Resort by the Chief Secretary and Secretary of the Division of Education, Innovation and Energy, Honourable Kelvin Charles, and staff of the division. They were encouraged to pursue their dreams even though challenges will come their way.
Dreams do come true. Things that you work for can come to pass. If you have a passion that is deep and that drives you, you can achieve. There's no limit to what you can do and to what you can become. Your only limit, yes it is, difficult times come. Yes it is, things may come to distract you. Things may not work out on the timeline that you initially wanted it to work out on. But you can achieve what you want to achieve.
And the advice given was well received.
A piece of advice from the motivational speaker stood out to me because she said that no matter what's going on around you, just focus on your goal.
And what are some of the students looking forward to most heading into secondary school?
Learning new subjects and looking forward to making new friends.
I look forward to making new friends most going into secondary school.
The students were also encouraged by the chief secretary to be wise when choosing their friends at secondary school.
As you travel the journey in respect of your secondary schooling, just remember, be careful.
The students received tokens from the division, whilst their schools received plaques.
A bigger German market for Tobago is on the horizon as the island's dignitaries attended the world's largest trade show in Berlin. It's coming up next after the break. Stay with us. They are really passionate about providing quality service. The staff members here ensure that you have a memorable dining experience. Thank you, Mobla.
You're welcome.
Whether it's your first time in or you're a repeat customer. Now, also happening this year, Tobago attended one of the world's largest trade shows, ITB Berlin. It was the perfect avenue to unveil the island's new brand and marketing goals. They earned Tobago positive reviews and tangible interest, including a few confirmations. Omidara Mills has more in this story.
Tobago's revamped branding, Tobago Beyond Ordinary, was officially launched in the German market at the world's largest tourism trade show, ITB Berlin. The tagline, unspoilt, untouched, undiscovered, was well received by the Europeans, so much so that the island's presence, along with its rebranding launch and networking, have already shown success.
When we did the formal launch 2 days ago, those persons who were there did in fact indicate that they were happy that we were reconnecting again with our market in Germany, and in fact they indicated that they were quite willing to give us the necessary exposure. As a matter of fact, yesterday, 4 new tour operators came on board, large operators, and they decided that they will market Tobago.
Tobago's contingent was led by the Chief Secretary Kelvin Charles. This ensured that negotiations and deals were finalized without delay. Marketing representative for Tobago, Angelica Wegner, is optimistic that the renewed branding and marketing strategy will attract more German visitors to the island.
That people are really embracing the actual fact that there is such a beautiful island, untouched island like Tobago. You see, with the current trend among the consumers here in the markets, people are looking for experiences for untouched islands. We had several wholesalers that will now feature Tobago for the first time because they were so impressed by our appearance here. Now,
Germany is Tobago's second largest tourist market after the United Kingdom. The positive outcomes from Tobago's presence at this year's ITB in Germany will allow for easier access to its neighboring Scandinavian countries.
Tobago remains one of the go-to places for the Germans. Additionally, we are looking at that connection from Scandinavia. As a matter of fact, a number of Scandinavians take that Condor flight and come to Tobago and other reconnections across Europe. And so we are very excited that we are once again speaking and connecting and communicating with our German tour operators.
Representatives from the Tobago Tourism Agency Limited were also part of the team at ITB Berlin. The team interacted with tour operators and several tourism and travel agents from March 4th to March 10th. It's expected that the work done at ITB Berlin will have more European tourists coming to enjoy the island's culture and unique experiences. I'm Amadara Mills for Let's Talk Tobago.
So if you are looking for a venue to host any special occasion, then Fairways has you covered. The restaurant offers very affordable packages for birthday parties, anniversaries, weddings, and christenings. They will also provide their conference room to host your business meeting. Now, Destination Tobago also took London by storm at World Travel Market 2019, and the island was recognized for its hard work in marketing the destination. More in this story.
Just 2 years on from the campaign launch, Tobago's marketing operation, Tobago Beyond, proved it's a winner, picking up the Silver Award for Best National Tourism Board Campaign at the International Travel and Tourism Awards. The honor was presented by the World Travel Market at Magazine London.
The awards that we won yesterday are really testimony to the fact that we are actually pointing in the right direction. It is indeed a team effort which has gotten us to this point. But when we found ourselves among the best in class and came off second, having edged out Incredible India, it really speaks to the fact that we have done the right thing.
According to the Tobago Tourism Agency, the island surpassed four other nominees, including Destination Campaigns, Incredible India, The St. Kitts Shout Out, Azerbaijan Take Another Look, and Feel Slovenia Experience Croatia. The Gold Award went to Tourism New Zealand.
We have branded Tobago as it really is, and we have done it in a very interesting, attractive, digitally relevant, and a modern way. And that sets the platform for progress. And I think we are all very excited to have been able to achieve that by a panel of independent judges who have awarded us as second in the world for 2019. So we are very happy. It's now to ensure that the product rises to that same level of the promise of the marketing.
Tobago was also among the top three of eight finalists in the Best Destination Campaign Country category, earning the third place highly commended title. Tourism Secretary Nadine Stewart-Phillips is attributing this success to strategic branding, effective marketing, and a collective effort. She says the Tobago Beyond Ordinary campaign has taken the world by storm, registering millions of impressions on social media and other digital platforms. She added this is the result of the synergies and hard work of the Tobago Tourism Agency Limited and Gravity Global, the creative minds behind the campaign.
We have seen growth in arrivals to the destination, and this is as a result of the collaborative work that was done with our marketing representatives here in the United Kingdom, our travel trade, our partners, and of course, our airlines.
Accepting the awards was a joint delegation, including Chief Secretary Kelvin Charles, Councillor Nadine Stewart-Phillips, Tobago Tourism Agency officials, PR firm Gravity Global, and UK destination representatives, AMG Limited.
The Fairways restaurant is just a few steps away from the 18-hole Tobago Plantations Golf Club. It's PGA designed to championship standards, so whether you're a pro or amateur, it's enough motivation for you to test your skills on the greens. And you know, speaking of green, Tobago recently held its first multi-sectoral environmental conference. It was the first step in forging a collaborative approach to dealing with environmental changes and challenges, with all the highlights in this story.
Tobago is known for its pristine environment, whether it's the beaches or the abundant green spaces. And we all have to work together to ensure our natural resources are preserved for future generations. President Paula Mae Weeks believes that this can be done through proper research and accurate statistics. She shared this belief at the inaugural Tobago Environmental Partnership Conference, entitled The Environment and Sustainable Livelihoods.
Statistics and the data provide deeper insight into our problems so that appropriate and lasting solutions can be designed. We have to know where we stand in order to develop and implement scientifically grounded research-based policies. Going forward, extra effort and investment are critical to increasing and improving the levels and depth of our scientific research.
Technocrats, climate change specialists, entrepreneurs, and policymakers discussed several pressing environmental issues. They included climate change, fostering partnerships among the public sector, private sector, and civil society, improving waste management systems, sustainable tourism, and fostering investment in the green and blue economies. They also shared ways in which the private sector and individuals can help reduce the degradation of our natural environment.
Get involved, get in contact with the nonprofit, get in contact with the environmental division at THA, understand what the issues are and do what you can in your community.
Managing your waste, ensuring that your operations, the impact that your operations has on the environment is zero to minimal. Zero should always be the end goal, but I know sometimes that that is not possible based on what companies do. But the goal is to really keep it as minimal as possible to ensure that your initiatives or your sustainability initiatives are part of who you are as an organization.
The Division of Infrastructure, Quarries and the Environment, Environment Tobago, and the Environmental Research Institute of Charlottesville, ERIC, spearheaded the two-day event.
Tobago needs advocates that can chart a course which will allow for people to hone productive industries from the gifts which are natural, ambassadors who are protective yet progressive. We are here to unearth dynamic capabilities by adopting a position on the environment, one that is not common but rather looks to forging and sustaining longer-term advantages arising from the environment itself.
The conference was held at the Monkton Bay Resort. The information and recommendations coming out of the conference will inform the environmental strategies formulated by policymakers. It is also expected that there will be closer collaborations among the THA, the private sector, and NGOs as Tobago continues to map out a more eco-friendly future. I'm Amadara Mills for Let's Talk Tobago.
We have to take a break, but when we return, we tell you about the handover of two new buses that will give a boost to special needs students. Stay with us. We'll be right back after these messages.
Come, let me go to Tobago. That paradise, Bombay, Robinson Crusoe. I'm to say, it's the land of tomorrow. Princess Margaret say, come to Tobago for holiday. Now the whole world say, come to Tobago for holiday.
If you are wondering, Fairways is open during the Christmas season, so come in and indulge in all their Christmas delicacies or sip on their refreshing signature cocktails. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy. Now, most children don't have to think of how they're getting to and from school. But for special needs students and their parents, this task can be challenging. It's why the Division of Education donated two new buses to schools in need. Have a look at this story.
Two spanking new buses were recently commissioned for students with special needs. And THA Chief Secretary and Secretary of the Division of Education, Innovation and Energy, the Honourable Kelvin Charles, was on hand to do the handover to the Happy Haven School and the School for the Deaf, Speech and Language Impaired. He described the day as a glorious one.
Today is indeed a wonderful day, because as simple as we may take this activity, it underscores very potently our commitment to those among us who are differently able.
And it was indeed a happy day for the Happy Haven School and an exciting one for the School for the Deaf, Speech and Language Impaired.
We have been challenged in the past and we really, really looked forward to this occasion where we can have our buses. I know that the parents are happy, our students are really, really elated. They are ecstatic about the bus because they saw little clippings of it from, you know, pictures that we sent. And I know that they're looking forward to being on that bus.
Assistant Secretary of the Division of Education, Innovation and Energy, Marisha Osman, stated that the vehicles will bring great relief to the students and stakeholders. She brought even more good news to those in attendance.
Very soon, I must say that not only will we be commissioning two vehicles, but in the very near future, we shall be commissioning a brand new building for the school for the deaf, speech and language impaired.
Also participating in the ceremony was Administrator of the Division, Cheryl Ann Solomon, who brought greetings on behalf of the division and expressed delight at the commissioning. The buses were then blessed by Reverend Dr. Glenroy Frank, pastor of the People's Pentecostal Church in Scarborough, and then it was time for the ribbon-cutting ceremony, which signalled the commissioning of the buses. Handover of the 24-seater buses took place at the Division of Education, Innovation and Energy in Scarborough. I'm Antoinette Mora for Let's Talk Tobago.
From Lowlands, we now take you to the village of Speyside, where the sod has been turned to begin construction of a new Community Emergency Response Team, or CERT, building. When it is completed, the eastern end of the island will be more disaster ready. Here's more.
Preparation is a big part of being disaster ready. It's a major part of Tobago's emergency response efforts. The Community Emergency Response Team, CERT, is one of those key units tasked with responding to emergencies from within communities. Now, CERT's response capabilities in East Tobago are set to be boosted as its Speyside Centre is being reconstructed. In March 2018, an MOU was signed between the Japanese Embassy and the Tobago House of Assembly. They are collaborating to ensure the success of this critical project. A contractor has already been selected.
It is my privilege and duty to announce this today that Towers Consortium Consulting Agency is the company that has been awarded this contract.
Area representative of Palatouville, Lansomi Speyside, Assemblyman Farley Augustine, is praising the CERT team for its work in Tobago East over the years. He welcomed the reconstruction project. And he's using the opportunity to remind Tobagonians to make themselves more disaster ready.
We should ensure that we are ready. Ensure that our homes are up to the building codes. Ensure that we respect best practices when it comes to our physical infrastructure. Ensure that when the hurricane season is approaching, that we are prepared. Because you too have a responsibility. Each of us have a responsibility.
Japanese Ambassador Tatsu Hirayama is also pleased that 1 year after signing the MOU, the sod has been turned to begin reconstruction.
It is in everyone's best interest that this project will be completed on time and within budget. First and foremost, the community will be able to feel safe and secured in the case of possible disasters. Also, our government will be able to proudly announce that our assistance bears tangible fruit in an efficient and effective manner.
And Chief Secretary Kelvin Charles says he's grateful to the Japanese government for supporting such an important project.
I must sincerely thank the Embassy of Japan in Trinidad and Tobago for its immense support towards the construction of this facility and its donation through the Grassroots Human Security Project grant, as was stated by Ms. Leslie, is some in excess of $200,000 will go a long way in assisting us.
The total estimated cost of reconstruction is $3 million. Japan contributed $1.4 million, while the THA will contribute $1.6 million. The project should be completed in February 2020. I'm Patricia Nicholson for Let's Talk Tobago.
We close yet another edition of Let's Talk Tobago, and as always, we thank you for watching. Please email us with your comments or queries about the program, and be sure to visit our website, like our Office of the Chief Secretary Facebook page, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Now, for more information about Fairways, you can contact 660-4411. From our house to yours, I'm Davia Chambers, along with the Department of Information, Office of the Chief Secretary, Tobago House of Assembly, wishing you a safe and very enjoyable week.